So here we have an example of the work done by a spring force, which is also a variable force. So we have in this figure, a cumin canister of mass 0.4 kilograms slides across a horizontal frictionless counter with a speed V of 0.5 meters per second. It then runs into and compresses a spring of spring constant K equal to 750 newtons per meter. When the canister is momentarily stopped by the spring, by what distance D is the spring compressed? So what's happening here is that mass, that cumin canister, has kinetic energy because it has a velocity. It slides toward that spring. It then slows down because of the work done by the spring. So the spring is doing work on the canister, slowing it down to a stop. So we have two things going on here. We have work being done by the spring force, and then because of that work being done, we have a change in kinetic energy. So from the work kinetic energy theorem, we get work is equal to change in kinetic energy. And of course, this is the work done by the spring force, and that's going to be kinetic energy final minus kinetic energy initial of that cumin canister. Now we know that the work done by the spring force is equal to 1/2 kx initial squared minus 1/2 kx final squared. And then kinetic energy is 1/2 mv final squared minus 1/2 mv initial squared. So again, note that the work done by the spring force, we have initial minus final, which is very weird. We haven't seen that before. So we know that the initial case, that spring initial compression, is going to be zero because we know that that spring is initially in its equilibrium position, which means x, our distance compressed or stretched from equilibrium, is zero. So because x initial equals zero, this whole term cancels out. Now we also know that that cumin canister is going to compress the spring and then slide to a stop. So we know that the final velocity equals zero. So that means this whole term cancels out. So what we end up getting here is a negative 1/2 kx final squared equals a negative 1/2 mv initial squared. Now here we can cancel out, we can cancel out both the negatives, just multiply through by negative one, and we can also cancel out that 1/2. So we end up getting kx final squared equals mv initial squared. And then what we can do here, since we're solving for what distance d is the spring compressed, we're really solving for x final there. So I'm going to solve this equation for x final. We get x final is equal to mv initial squared divided by k, and then take the square root of that whole thing because it's x final squared, of course. So plugging in numbers here, we get x final is equal to square root of the mass of the canister, which was 0.4 kilograms, times initial velocity, which was 0.5 meters per second, and we square that, divided by the spring constant k, 750 newtons per meter. And then we'll take the whole square root of that whole thing. So we have 0.4 times 0.5 times 0.5 divided by 750, square root of answer. And we end up getting a final position or a compression of 0.0115 meters. And then if we multiply that by 100, we get this in centimeters. X final, or D, they ask for, is 1.15 centimeters. So that's our answer. Now, one note here, if you use conservation of energy, you actually end up getting the same equation. So if we used conservation of energy and we treated this whole thing like a system, we have initial kinetic energy to start with, right? So K initial, and then we're ending with potential energy because that spring gets compressed. So we have potential energy final, and that's spring potential energy, elastic potential energy. So that is 1/2 mv initial squared equals 1/2 kx final squared, which again is that same equation that we got up here. All right, just we got it a different way. So there's multiple ways to do these problems, but here we can see that the work kinetic energy theorem works as well.